A Philippine senator calls on the Justice Department to get to the bottom of an alleged illegal visa scheme. See, the Immigration Bureau is under fire yet again after visas were issued to hundreds of foreigners employed in fake companies. Senator Grispo calls the scheme alarming, saying it poses peace and order threats. She adds the DOJ must act quickly in punishing erring immigration personnel. Immigration Commissioner Norman Tancinco earlier said over 400 foreigners were recommended for blacklisting for using fake Philippine companies in their employment visas. The agency has so far discovered 116 fake firms. It's also looking at dozens of travel agencies that may be involved in the scam. The Commission on Human Rights urging government to ensure the protection of public data from hackers. CHR Commissioner Fida Maniri Dumarpa expressed grave concern over the string of hacking incidents last year that affected several government agencies. These include the cyber attack on state insurer PhilHealth that exposed sensitive information of millions of PhilHealth members. Dumarpa stressed the need to limit the negative impacts of these attacks through a rights-based policy framework. The CHR stresses it is the state's obligation to ensure personal information that is stored in government's digital systems are secured and protected. The police official, tagged as the primary suspect in the disappearance of a beauty pageant contestant, a no-show during the preliminary investigation on the case, Jeff Caparaz reports.
Rose Camilon, the mother of missing beauty pageant contestant Catherine Camilon, never failed to attend the preliminary investigation of her daughter's disappearance. Catherine has been missing since October. Rose said she dreamt of her daughter Tuesday night.
Kagabi na po naginipan ko lang siya. Ang umuwi siya sa bahay. O nasa bahay na siya. Ganun. Yun. Normal na panaginip sa akin ang kagabi na umuwi na siya.
Camilon's camp, together with the CIDG 4A, have filed for a reply affidavit and a motion to inhibit against the Batangas Prosecutor's Office from handling the case. They say the lawyer of suspect Jeffrey Magpantay used to work as an assistant city prosecutor in Batangas. Magpantay is a driver bodyguard of Police Major Alan De Castro, who is considered the main suspect in Catherine's disappearance. They want the case to be transferred to the Regional Prosecutor's Office of Calabarzon.
Well, I don't know if the Batangas Provincial's Office will decide, pero it will lengthen yung preliminary investigation for sure.
The police official, De Castro, is still a no-show at the hearing.
I think yung publicity, he does not really want that publicity.
Well, of course, medyo masama loob niya. But I think yun lang masasabi ko for that.
Magpantay also did not appear at the prosecutor's office even if he voluntarily submitted himself to authorities last week to supposedly be readily available for the investigation. The Camilon family is dismayed by the no-show of the two suspects.
Kung sila walang itinatago, bakit hindi sila magsasalita, di ba? Sana kahit sino magtanong sa kanila, sino kumausap sa kanila, kung wala talaga silang tinatago, kailangan silang, haharapin ko kayo, tanungin niyo ako. Ito tuloy ho ito. Hindi ho po pwede nang wala, hindi ito, dahil wala ho ang aming anak eh. Hindi pa ho namin siya nakikita, hindi namin alam, wala kaming alam.
De Castro's camp is expected to file a comment on the reply affidavit filed by Camilon's camp on January 22. Jeff Caparaz, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine National Police has sacked Police Major Alan De Castro for his alleged affair with Catherine Camilon. Jeff Caparaz now joins us with details. Jeff, what more can you tell us?
Yes, Carmina, good afternoon. The PNP Calabarzon has dismissed Police Major Alan De Castro from the police service effective January 16, 2024 for administrative case of conduct unbecoming of a police officer due to immorality. PNP 4A Regional Director Police Brigadier General Paul Kenneth Lucas said earlier, De Castro is one of the suspects in the disappearance of beauty pageant contestant Catherine Camilon. In a press conference, the Pro 4A top cop said he signed a recommendation following an extensive investigation conducted by the Regional Internal Affairs Service. The case of Police Major Alan De Castro stemmed from allegations of conduct unbecoming of a police officer after a series of thorough investigation by the RIAS 4A uncovering evidence of an illicit and extramarital affairs between the respondent and the missing Catherine Camilon. PNP Calabarzon said they are committed to the conduct of fair and impartial investigations into the allegations of misconduct, regardless of their personnel's rank or position. With this dismissal, Carmina, De Castro is no longer restricted inside Camp Vicente Lim here in Laguna, and his benefits will be forfeited. Carmina.
All right. Just a quick question, Jeff, before we let you go. It's because of this recent decision now that he is going to be sort of be allowed to leave the premises, right? So, and it's only because that because he's a police officer that he's there being restricted within the ground. So now that you have this decision, Jeff, what is the assurance that he will not just disappear and become a fugitive and not face the charges against him or the allegations against him, Jeff?
Well, Carmina, we've asked that particular question in the press conference with a representative from the CIDG, Police Major Nilo Moralios, the Assistant Regional Chief. And even General Lucas said they will monitor the movement of Major De Castro until a warrant of arrest has been issued against him. Carmina.
All right. Thanks a lot, Jeff Caparas there. Philippine lawmakers seeking a probe into another brewing power crisis. And this time it's in Palawan. Energy rates in the province started to increase last year due to a power mess between electric cooperative Paleco and power provider Delta. The two entities were forced to enter an emergency power supply agreement, which prohibits both of them from receiving government subsidies. Paleco cites this reason for the increase in its power rates. The House probe is also expected to look into Paleco's performance. Just recently, House lawmakers also investigated the massive power outage that struck Panay Island. Philippines could see below normal rainfall conditions in the coming months due to the El Nino phenomenon. This warning coming from the Philippine Science and Technology Department. It says the weather event could affect almost all of the provinces of the country when it peaks in April.
Possible po na pas na magkakaroon pa rin ng malaking kakulangan sa tubig ulan dun sa normal nilang nararanasan. At least until April yung nakikita po natin na kung saan ito yung possible po na peak ng epekto ng El Nino in terms of malaking kakulangan sa tubig ulan. Sinasabi po nating drought or meteorological drought does not necessarily mean na walang ulan. So it just give you the higher probability o mataas na posibilidad na magkaroon ng malaking kabawasan sa tubig ulan.
La Trinidad and Benguet Province and Metro Manila logged their lowest temperatures yet for this Amihan season. Now, here's a question. Should we expect more cold days ahead? Let's find out from our resident meteorologist, Ariel Rojas. Ariel, over to you.
Hi, good afternoon, Carmina. Temperatures in Benguet and Metro Manila dipped to their lowest yet this northeast monsoon or Amihan season. Thursday morning, La Trinidad Benguet logged 10.8 degrees Celsius, while Science Garden Quezon City recorded 20.1 degrees Celsius. Other areas enjoying nippy weather below 20 degrees Celsius include Baguio City, Batanes, Aurora, Tanay, Rizal, Abucay, Bataan, Lawag City, Tuguegarao City, and Clark, Pampanga. And even as the present Amihan surge is already waning, residents of Luzon and Visayas continue to enjoy breezy conditions and cool temperatures, especially at night and early morning. Amihan is also still bringing light rains in Eastern Cordillera, Cagayan Valley, Aurora, Quezon, Northern Mimaropa, Bicol Region, and parts of Western and Central Visayas. Meanwhile, the shear line continues to bring scattered moderate to at times heavy rains in Northern Mindanao, Lanao del Sur, Maguindanao, Sokcergen, Davao Region, and Caraga. Flooding and landslides remain likely in these areas, especially those which received previous significant rains. Metro Manila also continues to experience generally fair weather with low chance of rain throughout the day. The Amihan will weaken temporarily this weekend, but a fresh surge is expected early next week. And no weather disturbance is seen to affect the country until next week. That's the latest on the weather. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Ariel Rojas there joining us live.